Hey everybody, it's the Last Robokai here, and welcome to the final episode of Let's Play Dawn of War 2 Chaos Rising. Last time we did away with the traitor, which was unfortunately Martellus, and today we'll be taking the fight straight to the heart of Chaos on Aurelia. And joining me in what is going to be a great fun road trip is...
Yo dudes, it's Cool Guy, and this is going to be a road trip on the corpses of everything we've fought on our way to get here.
Oh yeah, this is going to be good. We're going to have some music blaring, we're going to take the top down somehow. Martellus isn't here, he can't complain about it. And we're going to ride straight in, and that might sound like a metaphor, but let's listen to the mission briefing and it's going to tell us otherwise.
Commander, the demon Ulkair is manifesting in the ruins of Keep Selenon. This was once the grandest of our chapter keeps. Now, the Black Legion infests its ruins. Eliphas' forces are well entrenched and prepared to repel any surgical strike. Nevertheless, we will prevail. Predator tanks from the Litany of Fury will drive into the enemy's defensive line. Their mission is to destroy key Black Legion installations. Once the Predators eliminate their targets, my forces will launch an all-out assault on the Chapter Keep. With the Black Legion repelling our assault, you can drop into the Keep itself and strike at the demon.
We can supervise their attack in order to better prepare for our strike. One Predator will deploy in the Annihilator pattern, perfect for dealing with enemy armor. The other will use the Destructor pattern, better suited for dealing with heavy infantry.
Yep. And that's exactly what I meant by saying we're going on a road trip. The very, very first part of this mission, we'll have Kuga and I operating our own Predators, and,
this is greatest day of my life.
This was a great surprise when I first played this. It was like, I get to be a tank! You know, because that was literally the one thing missing from all the campaigns up till now, is the chance to just be a tank. Not a metaphorical
people
one.
People with mechanized hatred. I love it.
Yes, indeed. Especially after what Martellus did with his Predator last time.
Oh, God,
time.
Yeah.
The Predator Annihilator and Predator Destructor are deployed and ready to begin their attack. Key targets are indicated on the tactical map. The Emperor guides you to victory, Blood Ravens.
It looks like you're in the Annihilator pattern.
Mm-hmm. Yep, Annihilator pattern, twin link las cannons. Aw, oh, yeah.
Reading you clear and true.
And we actually do get some extra abilities with them as well. They can stop and repair themselves, a la nap time. They can throw down smoke, and my abilities are ability to throw a focused blast of the twin link las cannons.
Whereas I have smoke bomb launchers, a rapid fire for my auto cannon, and a ramming power called full speed ahead.
Mm-hmm. Yep, I got that one too. So I guess we'll go left to start with.
It would be really cool if my dude would not...
Predator Annihilator, Chaos Armor ahead. Use your las cannon to cut them apart.
Yep. And that's exactly what the focus fire does.
Excellent.
Oh, look at those. All those destroyed things. Apparently unselected myself somehow.
Good job. Oh, shit. I got another... Predator up here.
It's alright. Bring him in.
Moving behind him.
Understood. Strike with the Predator under attack.
Yeah, that's awfully nice of him to show his armor to us. And we get Terminator armor that
really?
We won't be able to ever look at or use.
How colossally useless.
Thanks, game. Unless it costs me lose
Destructor. Chaos Havocs are set up ahead of you. Their last cannons and missile launchers pose a serious threat. Use your auto cannon to eliminate them before
I can run over
serious damage.
Well, I'm going to take care of the Dreadnought there because he's got a missile launcher.
Hostile vehicle burning.
hostile vehicle burning indeed. Auto cannons and las cannons. It's party time. Might as well take this opportunity to just repair ourselves.
Yeah, particularly considering that my insanely aggressive ways have gotten me hit in the back a couple of times.
Yeah, it's got a bit of a cooldown, but you'll be fine.
Alright, let's rock.
Should probably throw down smokes next time that happens.
Another Havoc over there. He's using a heavy bolter though, so he's no threat.
Gunner, fire at will.
Back up a bit. Shoot these guys, pew pew in your time, your fun times.
One less enemy of man.
Yeah, not really too much else you can say about this. This is just so fun. I'm just watching us just murder the hell out of these jerks.
I love watching that Plague Marine bump around like a pinball.
Yeah. After being subjected to Martellus's, this is nice.
I'm gonna run him over.
Zoom! Speed ahead. I'll take care of that that shrine of naughtiness there.
Moved out of the way. What a jerk.
Destination confirmed. We have destroyed.
Still bouncing off you, man. Oh, there's
trouble. Oh, that's a lot of armor. I gotta back up. Backing the fuck up.
Yep, lead him on.
Predator under attack.
Holy shit, that's a lot of armor, and I just stepped right in it. Deploying smoke.
Victory for the righteous.
Our ally has
down.
The enemy has disabled the Predator Destructor.
We're deploying a tech marine to initiate repairs. He is in a Razorback transport. He must reach the disabled vehicle and initiate repair rights.
I think I'm about to go down too. Oh no! We might be getting to use that Terminator armor after all. Oh
hopefully
no, you get
those
to
guys
control
it. Are gonna back off a little bit. Razorback on the scene. Tech Marine out. Oh, fucker.
Just get me up, I can do it. I can take him, Captain. Look at this, we're showing off all the features of this level.
Excellent!
Predator under attack. Orders?
Tech Marine under attack.
Hostile vehicle burning.
I'm killing him. The dysfunction at the junction here.
Predator,
yeah, it's
attack.
A little late to run now, buddy. A little late to run now.
But run me
down. Ran him down.
Looks like you're gonna have to go on go on without
Predator
me, buddy.
Disabled. Send the tech marine.
Oh no, wait, I got this.
He's just gonna keep sending one out every time we screw this up.
He says the tech marine, like the last one made it away. There's dudes in that. Yeah, you got it.
Let's just remember, Avitus 101, what happens when there's a building?
Yep.
And a las cannon.
Tech Marine on the ground.
It's kind of adorable, really. What happens after that is he just hangs around? No, he gets in
the. He gets back in the Razorback and gets the hell out.
Or he just wanders off, I guess. That's kind of cute.
It's
I like
not
that.
Really a problem. Oh yeah,
very
he did get back in the Razorback.
Deploying now, brother.
There's something just ahead. I saw some rocks move. Yep. That's the ticket.
Smoked.
Understood.
Let's creep forward. Just run over a few ruins. Who cares about walls? Oh.
Deploying now, brother.
Let's see, pitch you now. So yeah, random little bit of Warhammer 40,000 lore here, just going off. Predators are another Rhino chassis model, which is to say that most Space Marines use the Rhino as a template for a lot of vehicles. And you've got the Predator, you've got the Whirlwind, you've got the Razorback, as you saw, which sort of is like half a Rhino. And What's really interesting is that the original purpose of the Rhino was a planetary exploration vehicle. It just happened to be...
I didn't even stand a chance.
It just so happens that Imperial technology before the Dark Age of Humanity was so damn advanced that, yeah, moon rovers, you know, moon rovers are really, really dangerous.
Oh, that's really bad.
Mm-hmm. I'm pulling back to a higher vantage point.
The enemy has
just... Yeah,
okay, now I'm just pulling back, period.
Get out of there.
I'm just moving to engage.
Look at this reverse. Whee! This is some beep 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 going on right here.
Ha!
Destination confirmed.
You might want to initiate self-repair. I think you can manage that right now.
Yep. Ooh, the tension. So we put self-repairs.
It is really a nice touch for them to blind you while that happens.
Yeah, it's like, oh man, someone's gonna come and get me. That's the other really great feature of the Rhino, is that it's built for exploring planets that previously might not have, it's probably overkill.
But what you're actually saying is that all of these things are metal boxes.
Yes, they're all metal boxes. Cursed metal boxes. That must be taken away from them. But, and because it used to be, you know, exploring hostile planets, just bumping that for no reason, it's, you know, it's really easy to sort of jury-rig it to keep it going. Probably less so once they start slapping things on, like, you know, las cannon turrets and whatnot, but yeah. Are they not going to come and send someone to pick you up?
I guess not.
Wow, how rude.
Very rude.
That's the rudest.
Go on without me, buddy!
I'll wait a couple seconds here, let my superpower charge up. Well, the good news is apparently Predator Annihilator couldn't stand. So there's that.
Hostile vehicle burning.
Okay, solved that problem. Mm.
Need to get that guy up though.
Orders.
Yeah, that twin length las cannon turret is gonna be a serious pain in the ass.
Hmm. Well, I can pop smokes, but I'm just gonna wait. Action waiting sequence, everybody. I'm just gonna heal myself up with repair vehicle, and then I'm gonna pop smokes. It seems to be the wisest course of action.
I don't smoke.
Apparently not.
Predator under attack.
Actually, the turret probably. Wait, shows what I know.
It's alright, he can't get me now. I'm reversing. Ah, jeez, this isn't going so well, is it? Why is it not appearing now? Is it like... Do we both have to go down?
God.
Yup. And... Where are you? There you are! Got you this time! You're not so cute now. Beautiful. I don't see that turret either. I must have killed it when I was reversing.
You did.
I'm the best. There is still that one over there, though. I've got to destroy that before we can get going.
Go forward!
Moving out.
I don't want to go forward.
Make haste, brother.
That was a misclick, but whatever. More smokes.
Deploying now, brother. Predator under...
Oh, God.
Excellent. Destroy all enemy fortifications.
Okay, seriously, we should really restart.
No. I got this.
Destination confirmed.
I think this is usually how my runs as the Predator go anyway, so.
Predator under attack.
Can't see me. I'm in smoke. See, look, he's confused as hell. Also, apparently this one's a bolted one, so, you know, whatever.
Suppresses infantry. I'm sure that just scares the hell out of you.
Yeah. Maybe if I was in infantry.
Victory for the righteous.
Like Metal Gear Solid. Box tank.
All guns! Fire! Target destroyed.
Well done. Strike Force Fury. Launch attack.
And that's it. Go drive over him. See you later.
And my tank is just sort of magically
forward. Repaired. Today we regain the honor of our chapter.
Sadly, that's a lie. All right, now we got a new mechanic to worry about. And it's gonna give us a few seconds.
Commander,
and
we should divert to support Captain Angelos.
Yeah, there we go.
By eliminating the Black Legion defenders, we can stem the tide of Blood Raven deaths.
Blood Ravens! Lord Eliphas was right! The Loyalists are trying to outflank us!
Go ahead.
Now, normally we don't get to control the tanks, but apparently now we do.
I'm okay with it.
So
I
essentially,
hate myself for my horrible tank piloting earlier.
Well, let's not make any promises.
What is this? More blood ravens. You should visit with me. I have gifts for one and all.
Who is this guy, Santa?
The demon is here already.
We are too late.
No, the demon is manifest, but not yet free. He cannot yet leave the keep.
Yes! Come and feel Nurgle's embrace, Blood Raven.
He's a little too excited for my liking.
The demon feeds on our brothers' lives!
Man, this is messy.
All guns! All
guns! Our ally is losing forces to enemy fire.
Yeah, so basically, the longer this goes on, the more of our dudes are gonna die. Could be bad for us. Theoretically. It tends to make him care when we go to fight a couple of them. Like, I'm guessing most of you probably figured that out already.
Your chapter master imprisoned me. Now, I will destroy his chapter, consume his sector, and rot away his entire reality.
A little less jolly.
Commander,
now.
Deploy your strike team and destroy that demon. Everything depends on it.
Jonah is going for Thul.
Yeah, unfortunately, Thul's repairing himself, but there's so much you can do.
Avatus is throwing artillery strikes over on the other end of this switchback.
Yep, sounds good to me. Please help back up. First things first, let's challenge this idiot. I never met.
Holy shit! Jonah got shot once by the twin wing blast cannon, and that was the end of his ass.
Ooh, he's over there, is he? Okay. On my way. Or perhaps even this guy. Well, I've used call to arms, but apparently it didn't get him up, so.
Our librarian has come wielding the power of hidden knowledge.
So many.
Yeah, it did. That retreat was back to Thul.
Oh well. This is really hard to keep track of everything, because it's
Jesus
just a mess.
Christ, no joke.
Jonah goes down again.
Yeah, I can barely keep track of anything I'm doing. More artillery incoming.
Our librarian has come wielding the power of hidden knowledge.
I'll just call the arms Thul, he's our big baby beacon. The more good stuff he can give us, the better.
Dude, I'm almost afraid to use the vortex just because I'm pretty sure I'll murder like half of half of Angelos' strike team. Okay, I'm gonna try to cut off this attack by that sorcerer.
Seems to have worked quite well. Look at him go.
Sarks!
So much happening. We've already lost like 26 Blood Ravens in all of this madness.
This would be way better than we did in some of our fights in the original. Jesus, that's a lot of units.
Yeah, that thing will be spawning units forever.
Artillery strike coming down on the temple.
Yeah, you know what? I'm happy. Okay. That won't stop everything from spawning, but it will stop that from spawning.
Ally infantry destroyed.
Okay, more incoming, and I'm throwing down another artillery. No, wait, I'm not. Priot is way too close. Throwing down an artillery strike on the missile turret.
I got cold arms going. I'll grab us that point as well.
A librarian has come, wielding the power of hidden knowledge.
It's just violence, violence, violence.
Part of my problem is that Jonah is on melee stance. I should really notice this earlier.
That might be a very good reason why he's having a bit of a struggle streak. God. At least the Dreadnought's died, though.
Damn it, we are still getting flanked.
Yeah, they will still be bringing in dudes for, like, the rest of the game. All we can do is just keep pushing.
All who die, die for the Plague Lord!
Dude, that is. He is Santa. He's so jolly.
He's the most evil Santa since Goldberg put on a wig. That's a reference, maybe only a few people will get.
I certainly didn't get it.
That's okay. That's consider it heretical knowledge and a good thing to not know anything about. At least we got Machine Duel all up in here. Basically, Thor just gets to run across the battlefield. There's another one. Just let the other one.
Just secured our flank. Sorcerer's down.
That's good to hear.
You're gonna get some artillery on that predator.
Okay, go for it. Although he's moving a bit much, so I would probably just let Thor do this thing.
Well, it's behind him now. Vortex coming out to deal with that infantry.
Seconds. Okay, we've gone a little bit too far. Where we want to actually go is this way.
If you say so.
Back up the middle. Although, honestly, like, they will be fighting a lot more dangerous and probably getting killed by a lot more things, but Gabriel's there. He can take care of it.
I hope so.
Probably not. It's alright, we don't get corruption for this. Things not going to plan. We got a boss fight up here to take care of, and I don't mean okay.
I commend you on your persistence, Blood Ravens. Even faced with the betrayal of your brother Martellus, you strive on. Such determination could accomplish a great deal if backed by the powers of the Dark Gods. as it is, your stubborn nature only ensures your destruction.
And there he is.
Oh, this I'm gonna enjoy.
You interestingly enough,
closer to your doom,
not going to get knocked down.
To the inevitable. That's unfortunate. Share in our glory. It was left to me to manipulate Captain Angelos into launching this attack. Aragast never understood the true grandeur of this plan, but you have played your parts very well, Blood Ravens.
Dropping artillery on those shrines.
Sure thing. We'll chew through this first one here. Because all they'll do is bring pain and trouble if we continue to play the exist. You're gonna want him to take down that other one too.
Allied infantry are dying.
Really not that fun to fool here. That's okay. Take care of this. he's been really been stunned by Thule here as well.
Jesus, Eliphas has a lot of health. 602,000.
Yeah, he's nothing if not a gigantic butthole. Okay, let's keep wailing on him now.
Yes, of course.
Prepare Thule in the meantime. So I wonder what the purpose of those are. Because they don't really seem to be doing a huge amount. Are we damaging him? Yeah, we're damaging him, so I don't know. It's really hard to say what the...
Oh, you fuckhead.
Ah, we got Nurgle ones now. Which means now his health is going to be regenerating. Now it's a problem.
Our ally is losing forces to enemy fire.
Does that mean he's just going to go through?
He's losing a lot of forces.
Yeah, they're all they're reaching critical mass of not a problem. Of course.
Fucking shrines!
It'll never be enough, not with Eliphas.
Jesus, he regenerated a ton of health there.
Yeah, Shrine of Nurgle, very hard difficulty. Good news is that, we're keeping him stunned, which is nice.
I'm using Empower, go nuts with your abilities.
Case. Go nuts with your abilities to find him a new. Oh, what's he doing this time? Nope, just knocking everyone silly. Okay.
I'm tempted to use my vortex power to see what that does.
Such a beast of souls! I shall tear apart all your worlds!
It's really unfortunate for Eliphas, but he's already facing up against someone who is already very adept at killing him. Okay, now we got trouble. I'm gonna take care of these things, and I'm gonna have Thule use this.
Avitus has to back off. There's just no way he's gonna deal with those bloodletters.
It's okay. I got full painting the altar of cold red.
Infantry destroyed.
I'm sure they'll appreciate that.
Oh, there he goes.
Call to arms being initiated. This for a moment so that it'll proc.
Our librarian has come wielding the power of hidden knowledge.
What the hell is going on with that one? You seeing this?
Bah! There goes Jonah again.
That's alright, I'm gonna get him back up again.
Try Christ, the Zeench are almost as big a buttholes as the Christ the Nurgle.
Wielding the power of knowledge.
They are long range terror. He's gonna need a little bit more energy here, and then Thul's gonna need to go into self repairs. Alright. Keep chopping at chaos. Yeah, look how much of a roadblock Eliphas is.
Our ally is losing forces to enemy fire.
Yep, three more guys are gonna go down, and Ulkair is gonna be at full health for this fight. But that's okay, you know. That's okay.
Devastator's backing off.
Oh god, false commander caught in a weird sort of zone of no actual do anything. Man, this is chewing through my energy.
I can fix energy problems.
Yeah.
Power going.
Just keep slamming him.
Blood ravens. But why have you battled me? How much stronger has Ulkair become?
Quite a bit, actually.
Victory is still mine, brothers.
Eliphas again proves to be a disappointment. His refusal to accept death is an offense to Grandfather Nurgle. Still, he served his purpose.
Refusal to accept death. Now, what do you think that meant? Jonah goes down again.
God damn. This isn't even my fault at this point. Something just looks at him and he loses half of his health.
A librarian has come wielding the power of hidden knowledge.
Yeah, it does a bit of that.
Vortex coming out.
Okay, then, Boss Commander running away. How's that look? Oh, well, time to make friends.
There we go, that did it for that bunker.
Yep. I suppose the ideal question is what bunker? Challenges go. Full of fire and hate.
Another vortex on the bunker coming out.
Okay. Another false commander wisely running away. That is not the false commander wisely running away at all. False commander, you fool. It's not worth it. Don't do it. I'm just gonna run around, pick up a few more medical items. Oh, false commander, plasma pistol, missing disco party over here. That's good. Look at him. There we go. Apparently, those bloodletters were just in the right position to cause him a great deal of issue.
Whatever, we had to have one for old time's sake.
I love the plasma pistol disco parties.
Basically, you have to have some culture.
Strange, though, with how strong Ulkair should have become. I'm guessing we did it? We actually beat the timer for it? We just had to beat Eliphas?
We must support them.
Because he hasn't gotten his health up.
Yeah, we'll see. I think that there's a horrible surprise waiting for us.
What, you mean more horrible than a giant corpulent entity from an entirely different hell dimension?
Yes, a corpulent hell dimension, or a corpulent entity from a hell dimension that's a lot stronger than its cards are showing right now.
A few more deaths, and I shall be free to consume the whole sector.
There's an arrow in case you missed
it. Your deaths will do nicely.
He's right there. Just in case anybody couldn't see him blending in with the scenery. He's very well camouflaged.
you know, the whole spine out of your back thing is very in this season.
Alright, now, the fight with Ulkair is... First going to be a fight with Ulkair and several dreadnoughts. Okay, fine. I'll remember this part. You guys want to be buttholes about it? Also, he's going to throw up on us a lot. That's okay, though.
That's fantastic.
I'm going to... Ah, dear. He's going for Jonah. You're going to want to retreat, Jonah.
I'm trying to move him.
I am... Yeah. So, generally speaking, there's a lot to the Ulkair fight. He's got a lot of AoE. He's got a lot of pulls, actually. He's got a lot of area knockdown. He is not a nice guy.
Eliphas is trying to run out of the fucking way.
Trying not to get puked on, but he does have like old bosses arranged that he will turn around and one drop at.
You're okay. Not gonna fight me proper. I'm going home.
Let's do this. Get a few more bonuses from Fool, cracking heads. Okay. Now that's done. I go, because this guy has a lot that he can do that is just a pain.
Man, that's gross.
Yeah. Like that. And let's just take a look at his... Oh my god. Okay, let's just retreat for a second. Turn invincible, run back. Okay. The good news is that he is entirely stunnable. So, yeah, there's that.
Oh god, what did you do to Jonah?
He used his intestines to suck him in.
That's disgusting.
It is incredibly disgusting. I'll just keep stunning him for a little bit here, because screw this guy. Okay, is he called more in? Okay, this time he's called in the slightly larger guns. So I'm going to fall my dudes back again, because there's no point in just like fighting this guy up close. And then he pukes on Avatars again. It's like, Avatars is just like, this is just the worst fight ever, why do you always bring me along for the puke?
Okay, I'm getting out of here.
It's awfully childish of you, Avatars, but I can completely agree with your decision. Fortunately, the more nukes they feed at us, the stronger the Force Commander gets, so there's always that. You guys wanna stand over there and pew-pew at us with your little bolters? That's okay. I'll just set you a little on fire. There you go.
Jesus. What? Just gotta lay there for a second and then...
That's all. Let's just, you know, Nurgle guys, pop a few wards. Okay, now we're gonna hit him with it. Look at that health chip away. It's very good. Also, get stunned, demon. This is what the Force Commander brings to the table.
Power.
Unfortunately, all my abilities were on cooldown at the time, so...
I'm still empowering!
Okay, you're gonna wanna run Jonah as soon as I get him up.
No. Okay,
keep
back
on yelling.
Purify.
Let me just lead you around for a little bit. Oh man.
Yeah, Thule's in charge. Yeah. I'm gonna get Jonah to try to
I got him, I got him. Force Commander is the Force Commander.
Damn, that is gross.
Ah, that is hilarious, though. I love that. That is fucking hilarious. Okay, let's retreat Fool for a little bit here, because retreating Fool is just generally a good idea. I'm gonna yell while I'm on the ground. It's gonna stun him. We're actually,
power
you know, all things considered... Oh yeah, nothing on cooldown. Also, probably gonna back up. Oh no, he's gonna do it again. Stop puking on me!
We missed this time. hold on. Purify. Okay, you're good.
You know...
This is the grossest thing I've seen in my
life. He's the best. This is the cool... Okay, fine, it's so funny. Okay, we got... Now what have we got moving in? Nurgle champions. These guys will mess you up.
I got it.
Does it involve orbital nukes?
It involves the vortex.
I like it. Pop that vortex down and I'll run away.
There it is.
Take care of this guy. There's one we didn't even know was there.
Don't stand before his might.
Get splatted. We got Thul back in the fight, which is always nice. Okay, well.
Where the hell is our target? Come out and play, motherfucker!
I don't wanna go over there. Did you hear that? Sounds like he's either eating or he's having the worst poop imaginable. I don't know if I wanna go anywhere near this guy anymore. There he is. He's throwing up. Which, you know...
An allied vehicle has been destroyed.
Oh no, not an allied vehicle. What are we doing? Yeah, get stunned. We're just gonna keep hitting you with everything we got. I will never not love that.
He calmly says that he's under attack.
I'm under entrails.
Power going.
Alrighty. Just gonna keep slamming this guy over and over again. Thul's just gonna keep on bopping. It's the way we do things here. Oh man, it is running time.
There is no possible way that can be good.
Well, probably wasn't as bad as Flee for Your Life bad, but yeah, he does pull out the old 8-pointed star. If that is an 8-pointed star, I will assume it is an 8-pointed star.
Amethyst is still fucking in there! Oh god, now he's gone!
not the wisest of moves, Mr. Amethyst.
Damn it, Jonah!
Oh man, I can't stop laughing every time that happens. I'm sorry, Jonah, I'm sorry, Amethyst, but that is literally the funniest thing. He's so...
gross?
So who exactly are these guys still fighting? Oh. They're fighting an invincible Gabriel Angelos. Good fucking luck, guys. He's at 291 health, and he is not going down. But yeah, I guess beating Eliphas before all of them die, I guess, because it used to be you'd have to be fighting Ulkair, I think. Or there was still a chance Ulkair could get all his health back in the middle of a fight. I'm guessing they patched that.
He's turning back. I'm gonna drop some more artillery on him. Because there can never be enough boom.
Yeah, we need all the boom. Oh, also, Thul, you're a little injured. Probably should have prepared you earlier. Okay, let's all roll in.
I've scorched, like, the entire earth here.
What is he doing over there?
Taking a huge fart.
Ew.
Dude, I'm convinced that's what that round pound seeming thing... What the hell just happened?
I think he either entrailed or he just... stomped. Oh, God.
No.
Oh, God. Oh, God. What happened? Why is this all his health back? No!
Our dreadnought.
This is the worst. Okay, why do you do this to us? I'm guessing he's either amping it up or the game just decided to screw us in like the worst way possible. This is the worst. This guy is a wall of meat. Do we really have to fight the wall of meat again? Get stunned.
For your walk-in woman.
Had all cares have to sit in the corner, and the corner is a stun. Destroyed. I've only got one heal left.
Yeah, sorry, I'm trying to heal a bunch of people right now.
Yeah, that's okay. No, I'm just saying I've only got one heal left, so I can't heal Jordan. Because, like,
there we go.
So much just yelling. Game must you. Look at that, I actually rotated the camera for tactical reasons instead just for zoom in on something.
And Jonah's going down.
Okay, I'm gonna fool him back up again. I'll save my heal for just in case.
And the lord has come, wielding the power of hidden knowledge.
Well.
Yes, of course.
Oh god, don't do it again! Damn it, stop spamming! That's what we do! Ah, the Force Commander's trapped! He's trapped behind bad terrain! Ah, this jerk butt. You've inadvertently killed me.
I may have done that.
Okay.
Okay, there we go.
The victory blood ravens. Death comes to all flesh. Even that containing an essence as glorious as my own.
What is he doing? He's just going back to the well. It's like, oh, it's been fun. See you guys later. Oh my god, what is he doing?
Amethyst is just like, fuck you, this isn't over.
He's trying to make this as theatrical as possible. What is he even doing? Here we go.
This is the way of Nurgle. But do not delude yourselves that your victory will last, little humans. This prison cannot hold me forever. It is cracked and weakened, and its architect now feasts on Nurgle's rotted fruit. You and your pathetic chapter will feel my hate again.
I think it was poignant that just before he exploded, the last thing that struck him was Avitus's last cannon beam.
Damn right!
Avitus is just like, this is over, no more speeches, you're 1 million health bar, more corpses.
All of the corpses.
Ugh, Jesus. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we often spoke about why we wouldn't do a Primarch run. I would like to put forward that that fight with twice as much health and twice as much damage that he does would be like, oh man.
Consider that.
Oh man.
I mean, I'm just look at our speed rating, okay?
I haven't even clicked continue yet. I've just been at the mission success thing, like just like shoulders slumped, a broken shell of a man.
I think that everybody at home should feel very fortunate that you get this after editing.
Yeah, I'm gonna... Oh my god. I'm gonna have to go through this and just... Listen, in post, I'm still gonna have me sitting here with my face in my hands going, oh no.
Yeah.
Well, at the very least, we've earned ourselves an ending sequence. And, hey, we can actually screenshot these things. Great. Thanks for the armor we'll never use, the flamer we'll never use.
Lightning Claw we'll never use.
And the armor we'll never use. And, yeah, Dreadnought Plating that we'll never use. And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Let's roll on to the credits.
Blood Ravens! Victory is ours! You have driven the Black Legion from the sector and banished the vile demon who sought to consume us. But a more terrible battle remains ahead. Our chapter is in the hands of a madman and a heretic. Kairos, he who should be the greatest of us all, has bargained away his soul to the powers of chaos. And we are branded as renegades and traitors. My brothers, this cannot, This will not stand. Commander, you and your brothers shall be our agents of purification within the chapter. Your actions have already set a shining example of honor and valor. And when none others could, you opened the eyes of Captain Diomedes to the corruption around him. Take the retribution back to Calderas. Diomedes awaits you there. You will assume command of the fourth company, rightly taking the captaincy left vacant by Davian Thule. When the time is ripe to strike at Kairos and the rot in the chapter, we shall contact you. When that day comes, we must all be ready. Let none find us wanting!
By chapter and emperor, let none find us wanting!
Lord Abaddon, it will be as I promise. The Blood Ravens will fall.
Yeah, don't piss off Abaddon the Despoiler. Just a note. and what I think is one of the cooler things they did is that Abaddon the Despoiler is he becomes the Megatron to Eliphas' Starscream in Retribution. It's probably the best way to put it. In that Eliphas will say something, and Abaddon will say, "What do you mean, your victory?" And then threaten to like rip his butt off and slam it through his face. He's not a very nice man, Abaddon, but, you know, it's kind of what Eliphas deserves. And as we all know, I've mentioned it before in the threads, and I've mentioned it before, and I think in previous videos, the Black Legion, Abaddon the Despoiler in particular, has a real bone to pick with the Blood Ravens, and they've yet to actually explain why that is. Well, you know, maybe in future Dawn of War games we'll finally get to the heart of that matter. But, yep, we've finished the completely pure run. Captain Diomedes has joined the cause of Gabriel Angelos, somewhat. We'll see how effective the convincing went in Retribution. And you get to head off to lead a chat, you know, lead a company. It's all very nice. So we all, you know, warms and fuzzies while Gabriel Angelos still has to be declared traitor to the chapter and everything.
We'll fix that somehow.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure it'll all come to a head in Retribution, and since everything has gone so well, we will be doing Retribution. Let's get these credits rolling, I think. Oh, once we get told how we're Angels of Death, it's beautiful. Look at that. Books and bullets and crosses, and that's a very nice symbol. Pure in the eyes of the Emperor. Mortis! That's just death, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Angel of Death. Alright. Now are we going to get credits? Yes, there we go. And this is basically just going to be showing off everything we've probably seen previously.
The team from the original Dawn of War to Chaos Rising really didn't change very much, which honestly I feel is a good thing. I'm a professional programmer myself, and when you have a team of talent that you just so obviously have with a lot of Relics programmers and creative staff and everything like that, that sort of synergy is so freaking rare. So it's valuable beyond measure to keep it together, and Relic did a very good job of keeping it together.
I hope they can keep most of them together with all the financial trouble that THQ's been going through, and it has impacted Relic. I think they have had to let some staff go, but I don't know if there were any of the particularly core stuff. Oh, we get to see the scout fall down the well again. See you, buddy.
Bye-bye.
Oh, man, like, gotta give them credit, too. Considering they're just using in-game models through all of these big cutscenes and a few other, like, sort of, you know, two-dimensional animations and stuff like that, it's really well done.
And it is a lot, it is actually a lot to take in as far as how difficult it is to animate, just because when you're able to go into a movie of your own, you have so many fewer limitations, simply because you can pre-render everything, and it doesn't matter if it actually takes you know, an hour for one second of video to play in real time, because it's never going to be playing in real time. But just all of the extra limitations that you put on yourself whenever you use in-game models are amazing. And you know, I mean, with everything that they managed to do with only in-game models, that's extremely impressive from a technical standpoint.
Yeah, yeah, and I think that sums up Chaos Rising in general. It is, like I say in the thread, it's my favorite of the three campaigns. You know, between the regular one, Chaos Rising, and Retribution, I feel Chaos Rising is the strongest. It's the strongest in terms of story, in terms of character, in terms of mechanics. I want to say as well, that image of Kairos, that is hands down one of my favorite pictures. Just the look on his face. And the,
what you gonna do? What you gonna do? How you gonna act?
It's like, you don't meet this guy until, you know, a bit of a way into Retribution. And you know, but that just sums him up so perfectly. Like, just there is just so much. Like, and they managed to make Kairos such a foreboding character without ever having him appear, which I think works really well too.
That's deceptively difficult, really. I mean, one of the biggest problems in building up a villain is making sure that, you know, the person who's reading, playing, whatever, properly dreads the villain. And that's exactly the reason why you get the trope of seeing the big bad guy just randomly kill some dude, because then you're proving that this is a guy to be dreaded. It's a guy who's supposed to be badass and everything like that. But they don't bother with those sorts of tropes with Kairos. They just do a very good job of giving him a demeanor that's very unsettling.
Mm-hmm. And also just like the little context you get, you only hear about him through other people talking about him, but particularly through Galen's logs, and you just, you know, he's someone who, like many people, didn't fall to Chaos because it was just something they decided to do one day. It's almost like he fell to Chaos because in the end he resisted as long as he could, and he could not resist any longer. I mean, he's been trapped in the warp for goodness knows how long. He ends up being found by his brother Blood Ravens, and they're stuck with him as well. And in the end, he's already, you know, on the verge of having lost all hope. And I think, and really, that's just he eventually succumbs. And
which is really one of the most unsettling things about the way Chaos is portrayed in Warhammer 40K as a whole. I mean, it isn't so much something you just decide to do one day, and then everything is demons, and you know, everybody has fun just being Satanists, and that's not how it works. I mean, it's a very subtle, maddening influence sometimes, and I think a lot of the reason you don't see mirrors in a lot of Warhammer's art is because if people who are in the middle of falling were able to look in the mirror, they would it would make them hit rock bottom.
Yeah. So we've got and like, but Kairos, they, you know, he's not going to be a sympathetic villain when we encounter him. We're gonna be seeing him in all of his way too far to redeem in Retribution. And as I said before, we will be going on to do Retribution. Oh, also, here is the last stand cutscene if anybody's interested playing in the background. I always find this one fairly amusing, just to, funnily for what's going to be coming next. he seems upset that he's killed the mech boy, like, killed the,
I always loved how the mech boys use a bolt like a cigar.
I just love that. The Space Marine, he's like,
the Mexican standoff.
He points the plasma pistol at the Elder, but he's got the chainsaw pointed at the mech boy. It's like, that's really not how it works, buddy. Unless that thing shoots bolts somehow. And as always, Tyranids. So we're gonna be doing Retribution, which is, you know, it's pretty much gonna be the Blood Ravens scenario, and only the Blood Raven scenario. If only because, you know, I feel people will probably want to play some of this themselves. It's always nice. But Yeah, so there's going to be that, but before we get into that, we are going to be going back and recording, and this will feel like a little bit of a break for us, because it will take probably about a quarter the length of recording time as this video will. I almost feel like we're going to have to split this up into multiple recordings, but regardless, we're going to be showing off the trader paths for all the other characters. Because there is essentially a trader path for everyone except for Thule and the Force Commander. The Force Commander actually gets a different ending of the game depending on his level of corruption. Probably not going to go in and do that. There is actually a different variations to each one based on the level of corruption you have. So you can only be minorly corrupted, but enough to get your first corruption power, and that gives you a different ending.
It's worth noting that it doesn't really change that terribly much, except for one or two lines in the rest of the game, and then the ending cinematic, which you can very easily Google up. We can and may set a good example of those endings as video responses to this one for you guys, but yeah, it's. Oh, it's overall not as dynamic and interactive as everything else is.
Yeah, it's really the one unfortunate thing about the Purity run is that Martellus is not as mouthy a traitor until the boss fight. You'll be getting to hear a lot more talk and a lot more interesting stuff from the other traitors as you go through the missions. So they will probably get their own shortened videos each week while we get prepped for a retribution run. And that'll be a new thread as well because, well, quite frankly, I've filled up the thread already with, like, so much war gear and so much crud. Seriously, I had to edit out one of my previous responses just to put the accessories in because it was like, I can't fit any more words into this. This game just gives you so much, and there is so much lore added to everything. There's, like, lore for your armor, lore for your weapons, lore for the thing that cleans your shoes. Like, they've probably got lore for whatever the area of ground she died on is. It's probably got a really elaborate...
They
likely do. Your mouse over it. It's like...
Now it's going to become a sacred place to the Eldar, and you'll get bonuses whenever banshees are recruited there or some bullcrap.
Oh dear. That's And honestly, Retribution does have one thing going for it, but... And I'll say that now because I'm not sure anyone's going to be listening at this juncture. They're going to be like wandering off and doing the washing or whatever. But is that it wraps up a lot of storylines really well. That's ultimately why I want to go in and do Retribution, because it wraps up the canonical traitor for Chaos Rising, which we won't be really going into for now, because we'll let that actually happen till all the big reveals. it wraps up Diomedes and his character role as someone who is completely and utterly pure, but devoted to the chapter, and has to deal with the fact that maybe I've wasted my life for this. It wraps up the heroes of Aurelia, and depending on who you choose as the commander, it also wraps up a few other plot lines like Eliphas and Abaddon there, or it'll wrap up in the Eldar campaign. It wraps up a great deal of the Eldar stuff that's happened in previous campaigns. Not just in the Dawn of War 2 campaigns, but also actually wraps up something that happened in Dark Crusade, which is really interesting. Orcs is just plain fun. There's already actually a Let's Play of that. And when we start the new thread, I'll link to McGrath's Let's Play.
It's amazing.
It is an absolute cack. I would only hesitate to recommend it, like, people watch it, if only because it's something that has to be experienced yourself. But if you've got no intention of playing Dawn of War 2 Retribution, then I'll highly recommend that you watch the Orc one, perhaps even at the same time as you watch ours. And, just... So many credits here.
So many people to thank. It really does highlight, exactly how difficult it is to make a top-class game like this. And even with teams as big as you've got here, so many people fail simply because you don't have that synergy that I was talking about when we first started. I mean, I've been bumping around various jobs for going on 7 years now, and I've been in places that clicked just right, and I've been in places that didn't click right. And the places that clicked right, I would be able to get more work done with 3 people there than 30 people some other place where we just weren't working together right. And, you know, but Relic did a good job of keeping that good synergy going. And, you know, I mean, this is the sort of masterpiece that comes out of it.
Although I do find it interesting, it looks like they got a lot of overseas Q&A there.
Well, yeah, that's localization. That's always a labor-intensive thing. Oh my god!
No, that was their Q&A. That was Q&A. That was additional Q&A.
Yeah, quality assurance.
Yeah, I just like it's out. Like I just found it funny because it was outsourced. Because you often hear about that, and you often hear that a lot of the outsourced stuff is that they will find one bug and attempt to reproduce it everywhere, which is great for Relic considering they have such terrible pathing. Then that's great. Find out how horrible the pathing is on every inch of the map. Might have done them a favor there. And on that note, we'd like to thank everybody who has been following in the thread, everybody who has supplied content for it. We'd like to thank Rulebook heavily for the rather amusing death tally, and Scotch DK for what was quite frankly one of the funniest pictures I've seen for a while. Thank you everybody for all the voting that you've done in the thread, all your comments on YouTube, and we will see you all with a few more videos just to close off Chaos Rising. But if you aren't interested in seeing any more of the traders, we will definitely be seeing you. And let's play Dawn of War 2 Retribution. I have been the last Robokai.
And I've been your humble servant, Cool Guy.
We will see you later, and have yourselves a nice one.